A very good morning to all of you. So today we are going to discuss about the combustion in CI engines, where it is having the following contents, which is working of four-stroke CI engine, combustion in CI engine, stages of combustion, the pressure crank angle diagram, ignition delay period, the factors which are going to affect the delay period. In case of the working of four-stroke CI engine, we are having four different type of strokes, which is the suction stroke, compression stroke, power stroke, and the exhaust stroke. So in case of the first one, when we consider the piston is going to travel from the top dead center to the bottom dead center, where the inlet valve is going to open and the compressed air is going to enter inside the engine cylinder. And in case of the compression, from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, the piston is going to move and the inlet valve is going to get closed. And at this particular point, we are going to have the fuel that is going to get injected, and due to the self-ignition temperature attainment, it is going to burn and the power stroke is going to come into picture. So, and in case of the exhaust stroke, again, we are going to have the exhaust valve that is going to get opened, and whatever the amount of combustion reactions are there, that is going to evaporate outside. So now we just talk about the stages of combustion in the CI. So we are having the ignition delay period, which is going to have two types of delays. One is the physical delay and second one is the chemical delay. And apart from this one, we are going to have the uncontrolled combustion, the controlled combustion, and after burning. So we just check out with the P theta diagram, which is the pressure crank angle diagram, which is going to have the bottom dead center in terms of degrees of crank rotation, and the y-axis is going to have the pressure inside the engine cylinder. So when we try to speak about the non-firing curve, which is known as the motor curve, which is represented as a dashed line, and from the start of injection, which is at the start of my point one, to the point number one. So this is the start of injection, and in the second stage, from one to two, you will be having the start of combustion, which is going to take place just at the entry point of the start of injection, where the pressure rise is going to increase, and it is going to rise the temperature at a higher pressure and temperature. So where you will be having the start of combustion and the compression pressure is going to rise, and we are going to have the point number three, which is the controlled combustion, which is nothing but the controlled combustion. And we have another one, which is point number four, the area which is covered, where you can say it is the exhaust or the expansion stage after the combustion. So I can say it would be the after burning period. So when we speak about 1, 2, 3, and 4 in all the stages of combustion, so first one, we can say it is the ignition delay, which is again having a problem with the atomized formation of the fuel. So in case of a CI engine, we try to get the compressed air and from in the intake stroke, and in the compression stroke, the pressure and temperature are going to rise, and at the end of my compression stroke, I am going to inject the fuel, where the fuel should atomize properly and it should mix up with the surrounding air, whichever is existing, and it has to reach the self-ignition temperature, and the ignition is going to start. So there is a time duration between the start of injection and the start of ignition. So this particular one is known as the ignition delay period. So this is again divided into two parts. So we can say it is the physical delay and the chemical delay. So we have two types. One is the physical delay and the second one is the chemical delay. In case of the physical delay, it is nothing but the time which is between the beginning of the injection and attainment of the chemical reaction condition. So the physical delay, it depends upon the type of fuel which you are using, the properties of the fuel, whatever is being utilized. If at all it is viscous in nature, then we can say it requires more amount of time in order to atomize properly, mix up with the air which is around it, and reach the self-ignition temperature. So this is about the physical delay. And when we speak about the chemical delay, so it is nothing but the delay period which is going to be there between the start of the reaction. So it may be very slowly that the reaction is going to start. This will start unless and until it is going to have the amount of oxygen around it, and it is going to slowly accelerate. So, and the total ignition is going to take. So this would be the start of reaction to the ignition that is going to take place. So this is about the physical delay and the chemical delay. And in case of the period of uncontrolled combustion, so there is one particular phase where the pressure is going to rise rapidly just after the ignition delay period. And you can say at the end of the delay period or at the beginning of the combustion, to the point of the maximum pressure on the indicated diagram, which is nothing but the P theta diagram. So where you can say when one particular fuel molecule is going to attain the self-ignition temperature, it starts burning. So there may be some different locations which is not similar to that of the SI engine, where it starts burning uncontrollably. So you can say this particular period to be the uncontrolled combustion, where you don't have any type of control on the combustion. So once the fuel molecule, if at all it is having insufficient amount of oxygen near it, and it is going to take the total amount of heat or absorb the heat in and around the fuel molecule and the oxygen molecule, then it attains the self-ignition temperature and it is going to burn. So the next stage is nothing but the period of controlled combustion. So in this particular period, it is nothing but the second stage immediately after the uncontrolled combustion. So where the pressure is at a maximum stage. So where it is having a sufficient amount of heat that could be taken up by the air and fuel molecule which is there, and whatever the fuel droplets that we try to inject inside is going to burn out without any type of ignition delay. So we can say that it is a period of controlled combustion where the phase rate of combustion can be directly regulated by the rate of fuel injection. So this is done through the fuel injector. And the total amount, it is seen that about 2/3 of the total fuel heat is released during this particular phase. And the last stage is nothing but the period of afterburning. So the afterburning is nothing but once it is going to reach the highest P pressure in the controlled combustion. So if at all it is going to reach the maximum amount of pressure, so there would be an expansion which is going to make the piston cylinder arrangement to move from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. And in the meantime, there is a possibility that whatever the burnt out gases or residual gases which are left over, if at all they find enough amount of oxygen and the fuel molecules, if at all it finds any amount of oxygen molecule, so already the temperature is existing, so it is going to burn. So still there would be a expansion which is going to be created by the increase of pressure, and the expansion is going to take place. And this particular after burning is spread over an angle of 60 to 70 degrees of the crank angle rotation, which occurs even during the expansion stage. So these are the four different type of processes or the stages of combustion in case of the compression ignition engine. And we just discuss about the factors which are going to affect the ignition rate. So what is the compression ratio? So when we speak about the compression ratio, when the compression ratio is going to increase, so normally the pressure is going to increase, and in turn there will be an increase in temperature. So it requires less amount of time where the ignition delay is going to reduce, and if the compression ratio is high, the ignition delay period is going to reduce, and it is going to burn properly, and we could achieve a good stage of combustion. And when we speak about the engine speed, so this is one of the factor. Whenever the speed is increases, so I can say in turn we are going to let the more amount of fuel than the air. So it is having more amount of fuel than the air. So definitely whatever the amount of fuel air mixture is atomized properly, so we can say the engine speed is going to increase, the ignition delay is going to reduce, and it again in turn we can say the output of the engine. So whenever you say more amount of output is existing, so which is nothing the power output of the engine, so I can say the combustion is taking properly, where the hydrocarbon is going to get disintegrated into the carbon dioxide and the water vapor plus the total amount of heat. So we can say that definitely there is a better vaporization and atomization of the fuel, and it is having sufficient amount of air, and it is going to reach the maximum amount of temperature or the self ignition temperature. So the output is going to increase with the reduction in the ignition delay. And next particular point is something about the quality of the fuel. So in case of the quality of the fuel, if you say it is having high viscosity, so it requires more amount of atomization or the air spill to disintegrate into small droplets of fuel, so that it is going to have a thin layer formation around the oxygen molecule, and it is going to convert into a heterogeneous mixture, where we assume to become a homogeneous mixture, and the ignition delay is going to increase with the quality of the fuel for the viscous fuels. And if the viscosity is less, the ignition delay is going to definitely reduce. And in case of the intake pressure and temperature, so when the pressure and temperature are more before the injection itself, so the ignition delay is going to reduce completely, and the oxygen molecule will be available at a higher temperature and pressure for the fuel molecule to mix up, and it could reach the self-ignition temperature at the same time, and we'll be having the proper ignition that is going to take place. So the ignition delay is going to reduce with the increase of intake temperature as well as pressure. Thank you.